Hey, this is John Sonmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. And I've got a question today from Sean about obtaining dev work in another state prior to moving there. So Sean says, hey John, do you have any advice slash suggestions or personal experience with getting hired as a developer in another state? I've read articles on this, but haven't seen a lot of firsthand success stories of this working. My gut tells me that it would take either a phenomenal online portfolio, big name on my resume, or possibly both. One of my goals is to move to a warm, snow-free state, i.e. Missouri to Florida, to work with a job in place as opposed to moving blind without a job set up ahead of time. A video response would be awesome, but any tips or advice on this would be appreciated. I really enjoy your blog and especially the videos. Thanks. Well, thanks, Sean. Appreciate that you like what I'm producing, and I'm glad to help you if I can. I've actually gotten several jobs out of state earlier in my career, and it really wasn't that hard. I don't think it's as difficult as you imagine it to be. In fact, I didn't know any better. I just assumed that mostly you get jobs out of state. When I first started out as a software developer, I was willing to work anywhere in the U.S., and so I just applied for jobs all over the place. And I didn't really worry about whether they were in state or out of state. I got several jobs that way. I think the key thing is it depends on the company and the job, right? I mean, a smaller company is probably less likely to hire someone out of state, but a big company like Microsoft or Google or Xerox or HP or any of those big companies, they're not even gonna care at all. I mean, for the most part, they're interviewing probably mostly people that are out of state. The cost of flying you out and having you travel to interview, it's really nothing for them. They do it all the time. They might even fly you first class. One time I went to a Microsoft interview, or maybe it was an HP interview, and they flew me first class there and back. That was pretty awesome. But they didn't care. They didn't care about the price because they're a big company and it doesn't really make much difference. They're more concerned about finding the right person. So I guess I would say if you really want to find a job out of state, keep in mind that the bigger the company is, the more likely that they are going to fly you out for an interview. So that's going to be the primary factor, right? If you're looking at small companies, you're probably not going to find that as much. Although I have even had success. I've had small companies that have flown me from, for example, from Florida to New Jersey. Don't ask why I would go that direction when you to the cold when you want to go to Florida. Although I will say that employment in Florida is sometimes a little bit difficult, especially on the pay range, right? In Florida, we don't have state income tax, so sometimes companies pay a little bit less. So just be ready for that. If you're living in, it sounds like you're probably living in Missouri, but if you're living like in the Bay Area and in California, and you're thinking you're going to get equivalent pay in Florida, you're probably sadly mistaken. So don't expect that. Another thing that you can do, another option for you, is to work remotely. So maybe if you've already got a job right now, maybe you can tell your company that you would like to move to Florida, or maybe you can come up with some kind of real good excuse why you need to move to Florida and see if they'll continue to let you work remotely. A lot of people have had success with that, and then you can keep your Missouri pay while living in a cheaper area to live in Florida. I actually did that when I first moved to Florida. I was working for a company. Of course, they were all remote, and we moved to Florida. And I was actually, it was like a pay raise for me because I didn't have to pay income tax or state income tax. Anyway, the basic idea is just it doesn't really matter that much. Having a reputation is always going to help you with any kind of job. Having a good portfolio is going to help you in general. But I really wouldn't worry about it. As long as you apply for big enough companies, and there's plenty of them. I think in Florida, you'll probably find a lot of defense contractors. So you might want to gear your resumes. Those are the bigger companies that will be hiring software developers. So you might want to gear your resume towards that. If you can obtain clearance levels, government clearance levels, that's going to help you with that. So, think about those kind of things, think about the kind of employers, and if you match up for them, a big defense contractor, for example, like Lockheed Martin, is going to have no problem flying you out for an interview if you're the right person for the job. All right, well, hopefully that helped you. Good luck in getting to Florida where it's nice and warm, getting out of the cold there. Let me know how it works out for you, and I'd be happy to help any of you out there who have a question, career question, or anything I can answer you. Just email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Take care.